Greetings, music makers. I'm Dr. Chiari, and in this video, we'll be talking about musical stories. Last time, we talked about how storytelling could be done through music. We looked at how music accentuates actions, enhances emotions, and influences decisions. In this video, we'll look at children's stories that were written about music, how art inspired musical stories, and how music can be applied to any story, whether it's about music or not. There are millions of children's books that can be read to teach about anything from relationships that have to do with friendship and family to school subjects that range from math to music. Here's an excerpt from Connie Schofield Morrison's I Got the Rhythm, which tells the story of a young person's experience with the rhythms of the city.
Ooh la la, I sang the rhythm with my mouth. I caught the rhythm with my hands. Clap, clap. I kept the rhythm with my fingers. Snap, snap. I felt the rhythm with my knees. Knock, knock.
While I Got the Rhythm was inspired by the musical sounds of a city, literature can also be inspired by visual art. After all, children's books are often interdisciplinary experiences. For example, Pete the Cat is the artwork of James Dean. This character began appearing in Dean's work in 1999. Nearly a decade later, the kitty inspired Eric Litwin, a storyteller and musician, to create books with James. One of my favorites is Pete the Cat, I Love My White Shoes.
Walking down the street in his brand new white shoes. Pete loved his white shoes so much, he sang this song.
Here's an example that shows you how art inspired a story, and that story inspired music. While our first two examples were books that tell musical stories, there are other storytellers that like to take their favorite books and turn them into music. This is Wes Tank, who started reading his favorite Dr. Seuss books to the beats of Dr. Dre.
Up his nose. Now I'll tell you, he said, with his teeth sounding gray, how the Lorax got lifted and taken away. It all started way back, such a long time back, way back in the days when the grass was still green, the pond was still wet, and the clouds were still green. The song of the Swami Swans rang out in space, and one morning I came to this glorious place where I first saw the trees, the truffle trees.
His rapping of Dr. Seuss's works led him to develop a television series for Kadoodle TV.
Yes, thanks. My full name is Wes Tank, nurse raptitioner, rap practitioner. I blew up rapping docs in the quarantine. Now I'll rap fairy tales for a living. Nursery rhymes re-inspired for the times.
Wes wasn't the first person to think about rapping Dr. Seuss's works. Here you see Methany Thornton inspiring her students in the classroom. My favorite example of turning a children's book into music comes from a challenge that radio personality J. Cruz gave some of his guests on Power 106 in Los Angeles, California in 2017. He asked his guests like Ludacris, Drom, and other hip-hop celebrities to rap Llama Llama Red Pajama, a book created by Anna Dudney. Here's what they came up with.
This is Llama Llama Red Pajama.
Hey, Llama Llama, Red Pajama. Reads a story with who? With his mama, hey!
Mama, kisses, baby, hell, llama, the mama.
Woo, the mama. The mama, the mama, the mama, the mama.
Llama, llama, red pajama. Listens quiet, quiet for his mama. What's his mama llama doing, baby llama? You know she starts pulling.
What if mama lemma's gone, hey?
That's when baby llama, yeah, she starts to fret. Then the baby, you say nothing yet. Llama, 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 red pajama.
I don't know about you, but I am so inspired by those rappers. Then I got to thinking, what if I challenged you, the listener, to create your own llama, llama, red pajama rap? Now, I know it might feel like a daunting task, but let me show you how very simple the rapping of the professionals really was. All you really need to know is how to use quarter notes and eighth notes. Let's take a look at Ludo's rap, for example.
Llama Llama, rap pajama. Reads a story with who? With his mama, hey.
Did you notice that all he did was sing four eighth notes and then rest for two beats? Llama Llama, rest, rest, red pajama, rest, rest, reads a story, rest, rest, with his mama. Now let's listen to Drum's rap. He also just used eighth notes and quarter notes.
Llama Llama, red pajama, reads a story with his mama. Hey, look. I said, mama kisses baby's hair, mama llama go downstairs, mama llama red pajama, calls down the llama, mama, mama says she'll be up soon.
Llama llama red pajama reads a story with his mama, mama kisses baby's hair, mama llama go downstairs, llama llama red pajama calls down to mama llama. Now I imagine you might be asking, where do I find the right beat? Well, remember Wes? He used a Dr. Dre beat, which you could find on YouTube by searching terms like beat, or instrumental, or karaoke. If you have an Apple device, you could use GarageBand. Let me teach you a cool trick. If you open up a new project in GarageBand by clicking the plus on the right-hand side, you'll be given a choice to create a track. Scroll until you find Drummer. Then you can choose any of the four options at the bottom, and GarageBand plays the drums for you. Go ahead and push play. You can change the drummer by pushing the face. You can also change the type of drums that you're hearing. After you find a beat that you like, whether that's on YouTube or GarageBand, get your book out and just start rapping. You should definitely try recording yourself, then come back and share a link to the video that you created. If you'd like to learn more cool things about music, click on the Learn video up here. If you'd like to see some projects that can help you make music online, click on the Create video down here. And if you want to subscribe to this channel so that you don't miss any of the resources I create about online music making and learning, click on my face. And until next time, keep on making music.